Dear students, let us continue our study in this paper, which is question document. And you are already aware with the forgery which happens on documents, and we have gone into handwriting analysis and the various types of papers. In this module and the next one, we will deal on inks, that is, what are the inks and its types, and then how to analyze them. After studying this module, you shall be able to know what are inks, learn the composition of ink, and able to identify the difference between different types of inks. As a matter of fact, we will go into detail on the key ingredients of ink, which are pigment, and also the difference between ink and dye. And we'll also study about the classification of ink. Let us begin with knowing what is ink. Ink is a type of colored liquid which is used to produce colored surface in different fields like painting image, writing text, or any kind of design. If you look back on the origin of ink, we have to turn to ancient Egypt, particularly the Old Kingdom. The ancient Egyptians used red pens, and for that they required ink. By 2697 BC, the Egyptians appear to have developed ink. Their ink obtained its black color from carbon black or from finely pulverized pin ash. These elements were added to lamp oil, which contained a gelatin made from boiled donkey skin. Unfortunately, this meant that the ink didn't smell very good, so the Egyptians added musk oil to give it a better smell. The ancient Egyptians were not the only ones playing with ink at this time in the 23rd century BCE. The Chinese were exploring the use of natural dyes mixed with graphite and water to produce an ink that could be applied with brushes. India was also not behind. The Indian ink was developed in India during the 4th century BCE. It was made from burnt bones, tar, pitch, and other substances. And writing was done using this ink and a sharp pointed needle. Let us now try to know what is the importance of ink in forensics, and especially what is the importance of the ink analysis. Ink analysis is a very important part in the investigation of questioned documents, including the forged checks, wills, or altered records. Although all blue or black inks may look the same at the initial look, but there are very important differences in their chemical composition. So, using the knowledge of chemistry and using various chemicals and the instrumentation techniques, as forensic scientists, you can do better investigation and you can come to know whether that document has been forged or not. Whether it is in terms of the alterations done by using that different colored ink, or it is the time difference between the ink, and so on. And all these can be revealed by the laboratory analysis, and the results can help assess whether there have been any additions or alterations to a document. Analysis of documents under a microscope can be very informative as a very first step. The investigator may be able to see even the slight changes in ink color, not visible to the naked eye, and that could be indicative of alterations, or there may be suggestions of obliteration and overwriting. Also, the ink itself can be easily analyzed by non-destructive as well as destructive testing, depending upon whether a sample needs to be taken from the document, a process that would alter it, or it can be done without altering the document, like the use of UV light, IR light, and there are proper instruments which can do this, and all this we will be studying in detail. And it is preferable that out of the destructive and non-destructive testing, first you should try your best to take the non-destructive approach so that the document is left intact for even further investigation. So with this background, dear students, let us now try to understand more about ink, that is, what is the composition of ink, how the dyes and the pigments are integral components along with other materials like dispersant, resins, polymers, humectants, defoamers, anti-foaming agents, pH modifiers, biocides, bacteriostats, etc. So all these are there in the modern day ink, and as forensic scientists you must be aware of these, because then and only then you will be able to do proper investigation once you have found the documents having these inks, and you can come to the conclusion whether the document has been forged or not. Composition of ink. Ink is composed of solvents, pigments, dyes, resins, lubricants, solubilizer, surfactant, some particular matter, the fluorescence, and other materials, and it varies from ink to ink. Each component has its own importance to make it more useful. Ink formulas, they vary, but if you look at some common thing, commonly they involve four components, that is colorants, vehicles or binders, additives, and carrier substances. The earliest black writing inks developed before 2500 BC were suspensions of carbon, usually the lamp black, in water stabilized with a natural gum or materials like egg albumen. The pigment may or may not be colored, and the solvent may be aqueous or it can be even an organic solvent. But the modern ink formulations are rather more complex. In addition to the pigment, they contain many other ingredients in varying levels. Collectively known as vehicle, these additional ingredients include pH modifiers, humectants to retard the premature drying, polymeric resins to impart binding and other allied properties, defoamer or anti-foaming agents to regulate the foam efficiency, wetting agents such as surfactants to control the surface properties, biocides to inhibit the fungal and bacterial growth that lead to fouling of these inks, and also thickeners or archaeology modifiers to control the ink applications. Printing inks contain colors which imparted by pigments rather than the dyes used in writing inks. If we talk about what are pigments, pigments are insoluble whereas dyes are soluble. Ink pigments are both inorganic or organic in nature. Most red writing inks are a dilute solution of the red dye eosin, which is an organic compound. Blue color can be obtained with substituted triphenylmethane dyes, which are again organic compounds. Many permanent writing inks contain iron sulfate and gallic and tannic acids as well as dyes. So these, you can see iron sulfate and and tannic acids, they are the inorganic compounds. Ballpoint ink, if we talk about, is usually a paste containing 40 to 50% dye. Most white inks, they contain titanium dioxide as a pigment, as rutil and anatase in tetragonal crystalline form. However, growing concerns over the known toxicity of heavy metals have led to the replacement of many inorganic pigments such as chrome yellow, molybdenum orange and cadmium red with organic compounds as organic pigments, which offer better light fastness and comparatively reduced toxicity. Furthermore, carbon black now replaces spielback, rutile black and iron black in nearly all black inks. In fact, the ink industry is the second largest consumer of carbon black. After knowing these, let us try to know what are the key ingredients of ink in detail. So the key ingredients of ink, they include pigments, which can be organic or inorganic, dispersants, which are surfactants and polymers, resins or polymers, which improve binding, humectants, which retard the premature drying, defoamers and anti-foaming agents, wetting agents, which enhance the contact with the substrate, pH modifiers, they are usually amine derivatives and they control the pH, biocides and bacteriostats, they are also used. Now, talking about pigments in detail. Pigments are considered to be the chief constituent of an ink and contribute about 50% of its cost. A pigment is essentially any particulate solid. It can be colored black, white or fluorescent, that alters the appearance of an object by the selective absorption and or scattering of light. It occurs as a colloidal suspension in ink and retains a crystal or a particulate structure throughout the coloring or printing process. Organic pigments in modern inks are identified by a color index system number that reflects the color shade or hue of that color and the structural and chronological details in the order of synthesis of that particular pigment. For example, the well-known blue pigment copper thalocyanin blue is PB15. The color intensity or the strength of a pigment increases as the particle size reduces, and the opacity peaks around a particle size is of 0.3 micrometers. The molecular structures of four important pigments which are commonly used in ink, you can see them here. One is shown to be the azo pigment. In azo, notice the NN double bond, which is specific for the azo bond, and you can see the conjugations which are responsible for the color. Then there is a copper thalocyanin blue, and you can see here the copper with the thalocyanin units are present, and this is there. Then you have a typical quinacridone and diaryl pyrrolopyrrole. These are the two more units which are used as pigments or the organic pigments. And notice in all of them, they are highly conjugated systems which makes them possible to appear colored. Fluorescent pigments have a variety of applications, such as in security inks to prevent forgery, in traffic light signals, poster boards and advertising. However, instead of comprising multiple layers of calcium carbonate and protein, pearlescent pigments, they contain flakes of mineral mica which have lower refractive index, coated with layers of titanium dioxide which has higher refractive index. After knowing about pigment, let us try to know about the difference between pigment and dye. A pigment is a dry, powdery substance that must be mixed with a liquid solvent like water to leave behind black, white or any other color. The pigment is not necessarily water soluble, but it may remain suspended in the liquid, much as in the case like a collide. Pigment particles tend to bond to edges within the chosen medium, and this is the reason why these inks tend to last longer and they resist fading over time. On the other hand, if we talk about dye, dye-based inks tend to be cheaper and they are water soluble. Dye ink generally takes more time to dry and results can be poor if a drop of water hit a page. So it will be spoiling that particular writing. Colors are brighter because various optical compounds are added to dye ink to enhance the color. However, these compounds have a low resistance to light or to UV rays, especially since dye-based inks are usually spread more thinly than the pigment inks on the surface. So, fading can be an issue if your document gets exposed to the sun if it is a dye-based ink, and this will not be the issue if it is a pigment-based ink. Let us now understand the classification of inks. Inks generally are classified into three categories or classes, and they are aqueous, paste and powder. The liquid that carries the colorant water is referred to as aqueous ink. Water-based inks, they come in two varieties, that is, it can be dye or pigment. Dye ink is water dissolved or water soluble in color, as they are cordials and are best in use. The colorant which is used in dye have a tiny size and allow a very small dot size which allows detailed images with smooth tone. Dye inks will fade in UV light, and if water is poured onto a dye, the colorant dissolves in the water again and washes away or runs. So, dye inks are not waterproof. Coming to the properties of ink, ballpoint ink is specially formulated to be thick and fast drying. Its viscosity is precisely controlled and it must be as thick as possible but still thin enough to flow down the barrel of the pen in response to gravity. Ballpoint pen inks, they use dye because the tiny particles of the undissolved pigment can clog the ball of the pen. Ballpoint pen ink is usually oil-based to give its thickness. It is because of the oil why the ballpoint pen ink dries quickly but is permanent and water fast. Fountain pen ink, on the other hand, is a water-based ink by dissolving dye in water, intended for use with fountain pens. Red ink usually contains the eosin dye, whereas blue ink contains the triaryl methane dyes or triphenyl methane dyes. Talking about the gel pen ink, gel pen ink is a pigment suspended as collide in water-based gel, and it is opaque and thick in appearance. Let us now look at the various types of ink. First, we have the Indian ink. It consists of amorphous carbon in the form of lamp black made into a cake with hide glue. The color of this ink, which can vary from dark brown to blue black, is governed by the quality of the lamp black, which again depends largely upon the materials from which the lamp black is made. Fountain pen ink can be divided into blue black permanent or non-staining ink. Blue black permanent ink, if we talk about, this is a record in which it contains about half the normal concentration of iron compounds with an increased proportion of dye stuff. Non-staining ink consists of no iron salt and is little more than a dilute aqueous solution of one or more synthetic dye stuff. Ballpoint ink is based on polyethylene glycols of suitable viscosity. They are non-hygroscopic and its dye stuff is of high tinctorial powder. Logwood ink is obtained by mixing chromium salts with an aqueous extract of logwood chips. Iron gall ink is a purple black or brown to black ink made from iron salts and tannic acids from vegetable sources. So, dear students, you have been made familiar with all these different types of inks, and when this is available as a part of document or otherwise at crime scene, it is very important that you should be able to analyze them and know what type of ink it is. So let us now summarize what we have learnt in this module. We have studied that ancient Egyptian ink is obtained as black color from carbon black or from finely pulverized pin ash. We also studied that in India, the black ink was made from burnt bones, tar, pitch and other substances. If we talk about the modern day ink, it is composed of solvents, pigments, dyes, resins, lubricants, solubilizers, surfactants, particular matter, fluorescence and other materials. The key ingredients of ink are pigments, which can be organic or inorganic, dispersants, which are surfactants and polymers, resins or polymers, which improve binding, archaeology and mechanical properties, humectants, which retard premature drying, defoamers and anti-foaming agents, wetting agents to enhance the contact with the substrate, pH modifiers, which are usually amine derivatives to modify the pH, and biocides and bacteriostats. So now I am sure that you are able to know what are the various types of inks and their ingredients, so that you are more knowledgeable when you are dealing with question documents which will contain these inks.